Before we begin, just a reminder that when you came into Mass this evening, you may have been handed a pamphlet regarding service ministries that we are sharing with those of you in the pews in a way to offer you opportunities to join in ministry in various ministries that exist here at the Church of St. Mary. So please consider prayerfully a way that maybe you could find to assist us in service ministries through that pamphlet and through the sign-up form. And also keep in mind that tomorrow is the ham dinner here at the Church of St. Mary's. So those of you who are here tonight, that starts at 10:30. And if you were wondering what to have for lunch tomorrow, it's decided. God has gathered us together to renew our efforts in sharing the life of Christ and being the love of Christ. So please stand and greet the presence of Christ around you and introduce yourself to those you may not know. And let us join together in singing our gathering song, number 589 in the Maroon Pew Hymnal, number 589, or on the screens in front of you. Praise to you, O Christ, our Savior.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, everyone. Gathered on this second Sunday of Lent, we come to encounter Christ on the mountaintop. There, as he is transfigured before the eyes of his disciples and you and I, we are reminded that in this transfiguration is our call, our hope, and our destiny. So we too pray that we might be transfigured into the image and likeness of Christ as we gather at this table, to be nourished, to be forgiven, and strengthened for the journey. Mindful then of our need for mercy, let us acknowledge our sins as we welcome God's forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, And you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son, be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord said to Abraham, "Go forth from the land of your kinsfolk and from your father's house to a land that I will show you. I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you. I will make your name great so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you and curse those who curse you. All the communities of the earth shall find blessing in you." Abraham went as the Lord directed him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, bear your share of hardship for the gospel with the strength that comes from God. He saved us and called us to a holy life, not according to our works, but according to his own design, and the grace bestowed on us in Christ Jesus before time began, but now made manifest through the appearance of our Savior, Christ Jesus, who destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus took Peter, James, and John, his brother, and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, conversing with him. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, Lord, it is good that we are here. If you wish, I will make three tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud cast a shadow over them. Then from the cloud came a voice that said, This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. When the disciples heard this, they fell prostrate and were very much afraid. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, Rise and do not be afraid. And when the disciples raised their eyes, they saw no one else but Jesus alone. As they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, Do not tell the vision to anyone until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. I have to preface by saying that I was not a normal child growing up. But as a child and as a young person, I always found the second Sunday of Lent to be odd, to be peculiar, to be, well, simply out of place. What was odd and peculiar and out of place about the second Sunday of Lent is that we always have the gospel story of Jesus being transfigured on the mountaintop. And I always thought, why do we have that on the second Sunday of Lent? Have you ever thought that? Or am I just abnormal? Okay, I guess I'm abnormal. Nobody raised their hands besides me. That's okay. I don't mind being not normal. But pardon my going off on this for a little while. The reason I always thought it odd and peculiar and strange is because, well, because the Transfiguration story is a resurrection story. It's about life. It's about glory. It's about light. And Lent is not supposed to be that. Lent is supposed to be about the desert. You remember from last Sunday, it's supposed to be about sin and conversion and all that heavy stuff. So why throw in a resurrection story on the second Sunday of Lent? I've always wondered that until I got a little bit older, and then it became perfectly clear to me why this story at this time of the journey. Because the church and our loving God understands our human condition. And the church and our loving God understands that you and I, like with New Year's resolutions, usually 5 days into it, we've already given up. We've already lost focus. We've already found it too difficult to do. So here we are, only 10 days into Lent. And what does the church and our loving God give to you and I? It gives us a God moment. It gives us some hope. It gives us some energy. It gives us some glory. It gives us a vision of where it is that we are heading. Because the church and our loving God understands that life is difficult. And if life is difficult, certainly spiritual transformation is even more difficult in our lives. So it's easy only 10 days into it to realize that, well, we hoped on Ash Wednesday that we would pray more often, and maybe we haven't succeeded yet. And maybe on Ash Wednesday we made all kinds of other resolutions that somehow we would be different, we would be more patient, we would be less judgmental, we would be more forgiving. And of course, already 10 days into it, we've realized that we've failed miserably over and over and over again. So the church doesn't want us to despair. The church doesn't want us to give up. The church and our loving God wants to give us a vision, to hold out to us why we need to do these 40 days, why we need to go through the desert, why we need to turn away from sin, why we need to judge less, why we need to experience a conversion of heart. So we have the story of this transfiguration, the story of Jesus being turned into something incredible, as white as light, as beautiful as one can have an eye behold upon it. My friends, the transfiguration story is familiar to all of us because we've all had God moments in our lives, haven't we? God, I hope we have. You know what I'm talking about, where all of a sudden you're going through life and something happens. There's some encounter, there's some experience, and it's like a light bulb goes off. And everything becomes much clearer, and we say, ah, God is in this moment. And then you and I, like Peter, we realize how good it is to be here, and so we want to stay there. We want to put up a tent. We want to dwell in that moment, in that encounter, and we want to stay there like forever. Because the experience, the moment of God at work in our lives is so incredible that our hearts are filled with joy, our spirits are lifted, and why, we are just filled with light and life and promise. Who doesn't want to stay there? And yet we all know from those God moments, those God experiences in our life, we know that they don't last forever. And as much as we want to pitch a tent, we can't, because life keeps moving on. And you and I keep moving on with it, and you and I keep along that journey. And even though we've had the mountaintop experience, we realize we got to go down the mountain, and we have to live life. And in the midst of living life, why, it's easy to forget those God moments in our lives. And yet that is what enables you and I believe, to be able to get through the moments when life is difficult and when we're struggling and when conversion isn't coming easily and when our hearts are not lifted up but rather are weighed down by the difficulties and struggles of life. That, my friends, is when we need to be reminded of those transfiguration moments, those God moments in our lives, because by remembering them, by then we can participate in what I like to call the divine flow. It means that even though life is difficult, we don't have to go through this difficult life by ourselves. We just need to allow God to participate in our lives. Allow him to enter in. Or, as the gospel story tells us, allow ourselves, like Peter, James, and John, to look up in the midst of our fear and see only Jesus. For me, that's the real miracle of the transfiguration story. Yes, the miracle of Jesus being transfigured before the disciples' eyes is a big deal. But I think what's even bigger is that the disciples, in their fear, overcome by this cloud that overshadows them, just like the clouds that overshadow our lives, the difficulties that you and I experience in life, and that spiritual journey that is ours, where we make one step forward and we take three steps backwards. Why? That cloud that can overshadow us. Why? Then there's this voice that comes from the cloud, and that too can be frightening. This is my beloved son. Listen to him. Listen to him. Be attentive to the voice of Christ himself. And then in the midst of our fear, in the midst of our being overwhelmed by this cloud, we, like the disciples, hopefully we look up and we see only Jesus. Because that's who we need to see. To see Jesus in the mundaneness of our lives. To see Jesus in our spouse, to see Jesus in our children, to see Jesus in our work, to see Jesus each and every day. That, my friends, is the goal. That, my friends, is the miracle that is ours today as we come forward in a few moments, as we hold out our hands, as we open up our mouths and stick out our tongues. However we choose to receive Christ, why, in that moment, hopefully, as we see only Jesus, that moment will change and transfigure our hearts so that we will go out remembering that moment, that God moment that is ours each and every time we gather here to worship and to be fed and to be nourished, so that we can go out and remembering that moment, that encounter, when our hearts were lifted, when our lives were filled with joy and with hope and with promise and with life, and with forgiveness, that you and I can then go forth living the life that oftentimes can be difficult, but living it in such a way that we participate in this flow of divine life that is going through each and every one of us. And we can do that, but we need to listen, and we need to keep moving forward, and we need to look up and experience the incredible miracle, seeing only Jesus. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate to the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, she has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in God, we turn to him this day, offering these prayers as we seek his help.
For all Christians, that our understanding and love of Jesus may grow and deepen this Lenten season. Trusting in God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and healing among all leaders and nations. Trusting in God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our community struggling with issues of addiction or abuse, and for those who reach out to help them. Trusting in God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the candidates in our area faith community who are preparing for the Easter sacraments and for their sponsors. Trusting in God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in need, the sick, the dying, and those who have died, remembering Darlene Lawrence, Stanley Lush, and Henry Weiss. Trusting in God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we offer up today, and for those we hold in the quiet of our hearts. Trusting in God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. O Lord our God, we place our trust in you. We give you thanks for these moments and encounters in our life where we experience you at work in our life. For those moments, we pray that they might transfigure us into the image and likeness of Christ as we journey towards you. Hear us as we pray. Answer these prayers according to your will, for we ask them through Christ our Lord. And invite our children to bring their offering forward.
Let us sing together number 643, Renew Me, Lord, number 643. It is a new song, but I think it's pretty simple to sing, and you will find it very prayerful.
Oh God, I seek safe harbor in this storm, a place of peace in which my soul can form, and inner strength to follow day by day your will for me unceasingly. Renew me, Lord, I pray. Oh God, I seek new vision clear and strong, that once again the sign that all turned away, I now may see more faithfully. Renew me, Lord, I pray. O God, I seek to serve but only you, for deep within my spirit you have sown the gift of faith, which calls forth boldness.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For after Jesus had told the disciples of his coming death, on the holy mountain he manifested to them his glory, to show even by the testimony of the law and the prophets that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so with the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and the blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched before heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. And so as he ate with them, he took bread. And giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead, and looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate God, on those who unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and this one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints, in the halls of heaven. With the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then, freed at last from the wound of corruption and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ who lives for all eternity. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Together we now pray for our daily bread as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those now called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be.
Please join in singing number 494, We Remember, number 494.
We remember how you loved us to your death, and still we celebrate, for you are with us here. And we believe that we will see you when you come in your glory, Lord. We celebrate, we believe. Here a million wounded souls are yearning just to touch you and be healed. Gather all your people and hold them to your heart. We remember how you loved us to your death, and still we celebrate, for you are with us here. And we believe that we will see you when you come in your glory, Lord. We remember, we celebrate. Bring the bread and wine to share a meal. Sign of grace and mercy, the presence of the Lord.
We remember how you loved us to your death, and still we celebrate, for you are with us here. And we standing by your side. Give to one another the temples of your love. We remember how you loved us to your death, and still we celebrate, for you are with us here. And we believe that we will see in your
Let us pray. As we receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us while still on earth to be partakers even now of the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Again, just a reminder, the ham dinner that's being celebrated here at the Church of St. Mary tomorrow, beginning at 10:30, serving until 1:30 in the afternoon. If your schedule allows, of course, we would love to have you return to partake in a wonderful dinner. A very special thanks to the many, many people that have already put a lot of time into the preparation for this dinner, as well as those who will be assisting tomorrow. We thank you for the generosity of the giving of your time and your talents. Wow, what a week it's been for our sports world in the Wilmer and New London Spicer areas. We want to congratulate the girls' basketball teams from both schools who are going to state this week. We wish them well in their adventures, and we pray that go Wildcats and go Cardinals, respectively, this coming week. Lastly, please join with me in thanking our men's chorus for leading us in our song prayer team. Our Mass has ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.